Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hey guys, welcome back. If you're new to my channel, my name is Allie, and welcome to Beauty with a Purpose. So, if you are new to my channel, my name is Allie. I upload 3 videos a week, beauty, Bible, and lifestyle. So if any of those interest you, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and let's go ahead and get into today's video. So for today's video, I have a Jesus chat for you guys. Oh, wrong book. Hold up. I do have a Jesus chat for you guys. As I was saying, I have a Jesus chat for you guys, and it's going to be over hearing God's voice. So I know that a lot of people are like, what is God saying to me? Like, I can't hear him. Like, I don't know what God's telling me to do in this situation. Like, I've been praying. I haven't been getting an answer from God. So we're going to go over that. We're going to see why it's important to hear God's voice. Who can hear God's voice? How do we hear God's voice? So to go ahead and start that off, we're going, I spelled John wrong in here. We're going to be going over John chapter 8, verses 37 through 47. I have a lot of reading to do today. I know that you are Abraham's descendants, but you seek to kill me because my word has no place in you. I speak what I have seen with my father, and you do what you have seen with your father. They answered and said to him, Abraham is our father. Jesus said to them, if you were Abraham's children, you would do the works of Abraham. But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth, which I heard from God. Abraham did not do this. You do the deeds of your father. Then they said to him, we were not born of fornication. We have one father, God. Jesus said to them, if God were your father, you would love me, for I proceeded forth and came from God. Nor have I come of myself, but he sent me. Why do you not understand my speech? Because you are not able to listen to my word. You are your father, the devil. You are of your father, the devil. And the desires of your father you want to do. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks from his own resources, for he is a liar and the father of it. But because I tell the truth, you do not believe me. Which of you convicts me of sin and I tell you the truth? Why do you not believe me? He who is of God hears God's words. Therefore, you do not hear because you are not of God. This scripture is a hard piece to swallow. Now imagine saying this to someone who has one foot in and one foot out in their walk with Christ. This is exactly who Jesus was speaking to. You cannot serve two masters. So in order to hear God's voice, you must be serving him. So as we see in this, sometimes we may think that we are following God, but how are our actions looking? What are we believing? Do we agree with everything in the Word of God, or are we just believing what we want to in bits and pieces? Are we only standing with what we like, or what about the truth? Are we standing with the parts that we don't like? Because it kind of makes us feel like, oh, well, if God's a God of love, like, I should be able to do what I want. Jesus died for my sins, so just let me be and do whatever I want because he died. Well, no. There's a lot that goes with that, and that's what Jesus was telling the Pharisees. It was basically like, look at you, like, you think you're following God, but you're really not. Who you're really following is your father, the devil, because you don't believe truth. You believe lies, and the father of lies is the devil, and that's why they couldn't even hear or begin to accept the things that Jesus was telling them, is because they weren't truly following him or the commandments that God had sent. They were really just believing what they wanted and from their own resources, which we just read that the devil doesn't even tell the truth. He just speaks from his own resources, not really of anything of God. So let's go ahead and read John chapter 10, verses 22 through 30. Now it was the feast of dedication in Jerusalem, and it was winter. And Jesus walked in the temple in Solomon's porch. Then the Jews surrounded him and said to him, how long do you keep us in doubt? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly. Jesus answered them, I told you, and you do not believe the works that I do in my Father's name. They bear witness of me, but you do not believe because you are not of my sheep, as I said to you.
My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one. So here again, we see that we cannot hear or even believe the word of God if we are not of God or following him. So if we are truly the sheep of God, we will follow him and have faith in his word. And therefore we would believe his word and we would hear him, because God speaks through his word. He also does use other followers of him to speak as well. But you have to be careful with those people, because you have to look at their fruit. So who are they following? What do they believe? Do they disagree with anything in the Bible? Do they disagree with truth? Because then they're not of God either, and they're not one of his sheep. And if we were truly of one of God's sheep, then we would know when he is speaking. And because we are his sheep, he knows that we follow him. So he is able to speak to us and us respond. Okay, so how do we hear and have faith? So what does that mean? Because we see here, it says that we should hear and have faith. We would hear him and we would believe in him, or we would hear his word and we would believe it, and therefore we would have faith. So let's go ahead and head to Romans 10, verses 14 through 21. How then shall they call on him in him who they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good things. But they have not all obeyed the gospel, for Isaiah says, Lord, who has believed our report? So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, indeed. Their sound has gone out to all the earth, and their words to the ends of the world. But I say, did Israel not know? First, Moses says, I will provoke you to jealousy by those who are not a nation. I will move you to anger by a foolish nation. But Isaiah is very bold and says, I was found by those who did not seek me. I was made manifest to those who did not ask me. But to Israel, he says, all day long I have stretched out my hands to a disobedient contrary. To sum this up, faith comes from hearing, and hearing from the word of God, which is the scriptures. And we can only receive if we accept every part of the scripture, but if we reject any part of the word of God, then we can't receive anything. So that's pretty much what Paul was breaking down in this part, is that this has been happening for longer than, so this has always been happening basically. People would hear the word, they would reject it, and they would not believe it. And so I have to ask you, like, are you rejecting the God? Are you rejecting the word of God, or are you accepting all of it? Because if you're rejecting it, then how can you expect to hear from God if this is his word? You can't reject it, but then expect to hear from him and know what he has for you, or what he wants for you, or where he wants you to go, or his will for you. You have to accept all of his word and be able to hear from him and what he has from you, what he has for you. So basically, to sum this up, there's basically just three things that we have to do. One thing we have to do is we have to be sure that we are following our Father, who is God, and that we're not following the lies of the devil, because then he then becomes our Father. And then number two, we have to make sure that we are God's sheep and that we know his voice, and then we can hear him. And then number three, faith comes by hearing. So we have to be listening to him, and we can't reject any part of his word, any part of it. We have to accept all of it, whether we like how it feels or not, we have to accept it. So yeah, I love you guys. I really hope that this helped you guys, or just maybe now you can start just reflecting and seeing how you can improve your communication with God, if I guess that's the best way for me to say it. So yeah, I love you guys, but always remember that Jesus loves you more. If you haven't already, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, go ahead and give me a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Mwah.